What up? Welcome back to the Necro Zoo. I am Bones. And in this one, it's going to be a little celebration. We got a couple of things on the itinerary. And that is that I finally built my Bane from the McFarlane DC Multiverse Last Night on Earth wave. I have some tips and a little bit of discussion. We'll take a look at them. And then at the end of this, I will be giving away some prizes because I did reach 400 subscribers. Now, if you guys know me, I don't really do this for subscribers or for views or anything. I just do it for my own personal pleasure. But I do appreciate anybody who watches and who comments. I'm a big collector, and I recently started customizing a lot, so now I'm like starting to get into that. But let's get into it. First of all, let's take a look at the Bane collect to build figure. Now, of course, this was highly anticipated. I had to go through four figures: the Scarecrow, Omega, Bald-Headed Wonder Woman, and Straight Jacket Batman. All really unique figures. Really, I'm starting to really appreciate the obscurity, you know, that you don't really think about these figures or you think you're ever gonna see them, and here they are. And they built a pretty cool, massive Bane. Now, this is going to be a little discussion, so I might go off on a tangent, but just stay with me. In the end, you'll appreciate what I'm trying to say, and I'm going to give you guys some tips, okay? Now, this is the build-a-figure Bane. And one thing I know from experience, one thing you guys should know is that I've been collecting DC figures for a long time. Of course, here I have my DC Universe Classics, all the waves loose, and I also have all the waves mint in box. I do go every once in a while and check those figures out just to look at them and take them in. Really, really the cornerstone of my collection. Love going and just looking at those. Those I don't take down from the wall, I just have them there. And every once in a while I'll just go and check them out and just see how, you know, actually reminisce about how hard it was to get all those figures and to still have them mint in box. It's really crazy. But I digest. So a little story is that one time I picked up this Calibac Collect to Connect figure. Now, this was when they were selling them from Maddie Collector. And what ended up happening was I bought the parts for this figure like online, and this arm, when I got it, it was just like solid, glued the peg was like glued, and I as much as I tried to put force in it and to move it, it would not move. So I thought about it, and I remembered that's how you take figures apart, is with like hot water. So I ended up putting it in hot water, and then I of course it started moving. So what I ended up doing was moving it back and forth until it got loose, and then I plugged it in and I was happy. I didn't have to call customer service or say, but what would have happened if I would have forced it, I could have snapped this peg off, and then I would have needed another arm. Now eventually I did pick up another arm, but this was like, this I just came across and I picked it up. But this is just to tell the point of the story. If you force these pegs, you're going to break it. It's not, you know, it's really rare that it comes like solidified like that, where I could not even move it. But I fixed it myself and I put it in and I was fine with that. And this happened years ago. So in other words, it's nothing new to put figures in hot water to loosen them up. Now, this time the Merciless gave me a hard time because I kind of forgot. I kind of forgot that rule, and I tried to put them just straight. As I got all the parts, I tried to just put it together, and then I remembered, oh, you know what? These are really stiff. I need to put them in water and then and put them in hot water and then, you know, break up the rigor mortis, loosen them up. Because if not, I'm going to have a harder time in the end to actually put it together. You see people like trying to put the head on exactly. And I mean, don't get me wrong. The head should pop on, but then it's going to just pop off if it's that loose. So you want it to be a little bit stiff. That way it's tight in there, you know. So if you have to put it in hot water, it's not a big deal. Just put it in the boil some water, put it in there, pop it on, and you won't have a hard time at all. It'll just pop right in. So now coming into this figure, I kind of knew that. So right away, when I started getting the parts for this Bane, I started loosening them up. So first I had the hands, and I would loosen them up. I put them in hot water. I loosened up that joint with the peg. I got the arms, and then they have that like ball peg that sticks out, and they were really stiff. But once I put it in water, and then I started like massaging it, getting it loose, breaking up those little pieces in the cog that like ratchet it, clack, 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 to where I got it to be real smooth. Okay, now if I never would have done this, I would have a hard time right now. Why? Because the joints would be really stiff. So what I did notice was that the hands, they have like that, like a plug, right? And then the wrist had like a socket, like a hole. You could soften up the socket, but you can't soften up that peg. That peg is like made out of like a harder plastic, and it's the same one that's on the lower torso that the leg actually goes into. But you can soften the porthole, the hole part, that when you put that in hot water, it like gets squishy, which will like let you push it all the way in, and then you just let it, you know, cool back down, and then you should be good to go. So I already had the hands on here before I even got started to put this together. But then I went ahead and I actually put the lower torso in hot water. Now the reason I did that is because there's also some pegs inside here under his like shorts. And I wanted to make sure that those were loose as well, so they could move around, so it wouldn't be stiff once I put it together. Now, what ends up happening is you have this joint, right? Now, if it's stiff, it's not gonna move. So, you know, soften it up. And then once you soften it up, you know, massage it out. That way it's real easy to manipulate. So one of the bigger problems was these knee joints. So I figured out what started happening was that people were putting in the plug, but the knee joint itself was actually super stiff, like really stiff. So when they tried to bend this knee, they put so much force in it that it would pop the plug out from the lower thigh. I mean, the from under the shorts, it would just pop right off, because it was kind of like putting a lever and putting all the force, and it would just pop right out. So I spent my time loosening up this knee joint. I had to put it in water. One of them was a little bit smoother than the other, but every once in a while I would see that leg and I would start, you know, pumping it, grinding it, loosening it up, to where I finally made it to this day that I was going to put them together. And I knew that it would be so loose that I would be able to hold his leg and then bend the knee. Look at that, with fingers. Now, why is that? Because I loosened up this knee joint. If I wouldn't have loosened up this knee joint, I would push this down and this part would pop out. But since I spent my time prepping the figure, which, don't get me wrong, you shouldn't have to do, but it comes with the territory. I mean, if you know what you're doing, you know not to force it. right? So the knee works nice and clean. It doesn't pop out of the leg. The leg doesn't pop out. And actually, by doing this, I got them to be real. Like, I got all the articulation that they had planned under these shorts. Now, one thing you got to know is that be careful, because the shorts are what let you do the articulation, right, as much as you want. But by doing this, you spread out those shorts. Now, they will go back, but you kind of don't want them, you know, doing crazy moves, because then it, like, messes up the shorts. It will go back, but Bane doesn't do the splits. Bane doesn't, you know, do nothing like that. So you shouldn't be moving them so much. But if you wanted to, you could get them. Look at that. And then look at this. Look at that. All right. So that's all I want to say about prepping the figure. Prep it. If it's really tight, put it in water, loosen it up, and then break it free. So the day you go to assemble your figure, it's already loose enough where you could pop it in and have free range of movement. Because if you don't do that, you'll pop it in and then you'll be trying to force this, and you might snap off the arm. Or like what was happening to a lot of people, that they were trying to bend this knee and they were popping out the plug from here, from that porthole. So I actually got a lot of really cool articulation. People were saying they wanted him to, like, bend the knee, like when he broke Batman's back. Well, look, I could kind of do it. The only thing bad is that you, like, wrinkle up the shorts. But once you put the leg back, it goes back the same way. So that's all I want to talk about assembling the figure. That, you know, I also threw the head in hot water because I had seen people trying to force this head down. And trust me, when I popped that head on, I just did it with one finger and it popped right on, and then I just left it alone. Right? It's on there. Now, I really don't like when people push it. They know that the head ain't going up any further, and then they push it and it pops off, and they're like, oh, McFarlane suck. Well, why'd you do that? Look at it. You can see it's not going to have any more range of motion. That's it. That's it. Which is, for Bane, that's pretty good. But don't force it. Take care of your figures. These are not really made for little kids. These are adult collectors. People that like to collect these and take care of them. Okay? So, saying all that, let's go ahead and take a look at Bane. Alright guys, starting off with the head. As I said before, he has minimal head articulation, but he does look down. He only looks straight forward, but he does have tilt to the sides, and he could turn his head. Okay. Coming down to the chest, really cool texturing on the wife beater. You got little nicks and different textures. The chest, you got the striations. Look at the veins and the muscles in his neck. Beautiful, beautiful sculpt work. Okay, moving on to the shoulder. Does not have the butterfly joint, but he does have enough space where it'll rock back and forth. Single jointed elbow. But he does have that crazy elbow swivel going down to the wrist and the fist. Like I said before, you have to find that sweet spot where it lets you do the articulation right there. But if you turn it, the articulation's a little bit stiffer. Why? Because it doesn't have as much room in that one spot. Look at that. Okay. But beautiful sculpt on the gloves. Move down to the belt, and an awesome, awesome Bane belt. This is the first time you've seen Bane with like overly exaggerated pouches and straps, but actually I'm liking it. It looks pretty cool, pretty military style. Of course, you got that the shortcuts, but that's to give him mobility so he can move. You got that thigh swivel, that thigh cut, and that is where that socket goes into that porthole. So just gotta heat it up and then stick it in there and then let it cool down, and you should not have a problem at all. Then it has a knee swivel. Now this is real crazy. This ankle rocker that's on here, they should make all the figures. This is the feet they should do. That's what I would do. Why? Because you don't have those crazy ball joints, and you still get the rocker, and then you get up and down, and then toe articulation. Sculpt work on the boots is just perfect, really thick and stocky. Other side's the same. Looking at him from the bottom, he got some pretty cool treads. Going up, the same, a lot of straps, lots of buckles. This is gonna be a lot of cool work that when I customize my other one, I have a plan of like painting in some straps, the buckles. I think I wanna make these knuckle dots red, like the dot on his belt. And then I'm gonna think about adding some tubes to the back of his head, at least one or two, but we'll see about that. Going up, awesome sculpt on the back, pretty cool, awesome. He does have waist rotation, pretty good for a big figure. So anyways, guys, I'm happy with him. That's a cool Bane figure. Of course, I love me some Bane. Not sad at all. When I do my custom, I will probably put him in regular skin tone with like a little bit of green for the veins, and then just add some different colors. I'm happy with him. Like I said, if you do it right, you should be able to get all the articulation you want. Okay. You know what? Let's do a little bit of comparisons. Let's go ahead and bring in this Mattel KGB Beast. Bane is huge. Let's go ahead and bring in again my Hellbat armor that I'm working on. Oh, gives him a good run for his money, but Bane is still a slight bit bigger and taller and thicker. And then finally, let's bring in the Merciless. Pretty close, but Bane is still a big chunk of plastic. Cool for the collection. I'm gonna be really happy to get him up there on the shelf. Now, let's go ahead and talk about this. What I'm gonna do is, if you wanna be entered into the raffle, then make a comment down below, and I want you to answer, what are two characters that you want McFarlane to go ahead and tackle? One could be a regular figure, and then one has to be a collect build figure. So I'm gonna pick Lobo as my regular figure, because if they make them around the size of the Devastator or even the Hellbat, they could make a pretty good size Lobo without having to be a build figure. And then my collect build figure, I want it to be Solomon Grundy. I just think McFarlane would have a pretty crazy take on the Grundy head sculpt because it's like Frankenstein-ish. But those are my picks. So comment down below what your picks are. Now, if you comment, I'm only going to put your name in the raffle once. But if you have a channel and you make a video, I will put your name twice. So that gives you two more, you know, another double chance to win. So let's get it again straight. If you comment down below and say you want to enter, I'm only going to put your name once. But if you have a channel and you make a video and then answer the question, which is what figures you would like McFarlane to come out with next, then I'll put you down for two entries. Now, there's going to be two prizes. Of course, the first prize is going to be the Merciless. So if you are the last man standing, then you're going to get the Merciless. But the runner-up, number two, is going to get this two-pack Arkham Asylum from McFarlane's DC Multiverse that has the Arkham Batman and Joker, but they're like damaged or like full of like toxic venom. So in the end, if you guys want to switch, that's up to you. But the last person called will win the Merciless, and the runner-up will win this two-pack. Anyways, guys, that's it for now. Thanks to everybody that watches or that spreads the word. If anybody wants to enter, they just have to subscribe and then make a comment or make a video. Let me know if you make a video so I can check it out. And we're going to go until next Saturday. So next Saturday will be the cutoff day. And then I guess Sunday I'll do the actual raffle and we'll see who wins. If nobody enters, then no biggie for me because I don't have to ship anything. But if you're interested, go ahead. Thanks for watching, everybody. Stay safe out there. Stay collecting. And I will see you on the next one.